Takt time versus cycle time, the crucial difference for builders. Honestly, I'm so excited about this video. The concept of cycle time versus takt time versus lead time versus the overall throughput, these are terms that we need to understand that once we program into our mindset, will really change everything from a productivity standpoint. So I'm going to talk about the differences visually, explain what we can do with all of them, and how we can approach our project sites in a new light, in a new way, and really hope to leave you invigorated about understanding these concepts and specific things that you can do in your work tomorrow to increase your overall productivity. So if you're into that, this is your video. Okay, so I love this concept. Let me tell you where this started for me. So I've been studying takt time and takt planning for a long time, and the term cycle time, throughput, all of the, you know, work in process, right? All of these things as they relate to each other in different formulas is something that kind of eluded me when I first started in construction. And I always remember the manufacturing homies chiding us ignorant construction folks for not knowing the difference and really kind of looking down on us. And I was like, okay, let's go ahead and figure this out. So after quite a bit of research, I found out, at least for myself, what is the difference between takt time and cycle time, and exactly how does it apply to construction in remarkable ways, and that's what we're going to show you right now. So let me get right into it and talk about some concepts. I want to anchor you to this image here that I've drawn in the background. Most of the time, all we ever talk about is the activity and the activity duration in construction. That's the center focus, that's what we track from a productivity standpoint, but that's not everything. Let me go ahead and talk about takt time and cycle time. So when you prepare or begin an activity for one unit or one zone or one work package in a zone, you have your preparation time and then the time it actually takes to create or complete that activity and finish it. This is called the cycle time, okay? So cycle time right here, the takt time is when you are producing multiple activities on a rhythm, the takt time is the rate of production, okay, that meets the customer demand and sets the overall pace. So these are two very different things. So if you look at the activity as the base, the takt time is how often, let me do a little clap of the hands, how often do we have to produce this activity on a rhythm. Takt is an older German word for rhythm or baton, so the rhythm. So the takt time is how frequent or at what interval will I produce subsequent or repetitive activities, and the cycle time is how long it takes from start to finish to produce one unit or one work package in a zone. And then I would say over here, this is the lead time, and then throughput is the amount, a certain amount of product, how long it takes to move it through a system. So we could also visualize throughput here as well, but I'd like to focus on takt time, cycle time, and lead time. And this is all around the basis of design, detail, fab, deliver. This is the lead time before you can actually start the activity. All steps to complete that activity for one unit is the cycle time, and the takt time is the rhythm at which they're produced. I really like that image. So let me talk about the specific definitions one by one to anchor us before I explain exactly what we should be doing with it. Number one, cycle time, the time it takes to complete one unit or one work package in a zone. Lead time is the total time taken to deliver the work throughout the whole process until the point of shipping, dispatch, or production readiness. Customer lead time is the total time from the customer order to when the product has been delivered. Takt time is how much time you have for each product to be delivered, for each product to be processed. And then throughput is the rate at which a grouping of products can be produced and make its way through the system. So the reason that these are important is twofold. Number one, from a takt time standpoint, This helps us to control the speed of production and the overall customer lead time to narrow that. And then the cycle time allows us to really analyze our individual activities and the steps within those activities and really do better from a production standpoint. So I'm not going to get into the exact details of the formulas here. There's a lot of math behind this. Let me tell you how it applies to builders and construction. So first of all, the takt time. I've explained in other videos, and I'll do it again, that if you consider the activity here or the work package within a takt wagon, and this is called a takt wagon, and you have your takt time, you can use the formula takt, and these are zones, so this would be zone 1 and 2. Takt wagons plus takt zones minus 1 multiplied by the takt time equals the overall duration. That formula allows us to do a couple of neat things. It allows us to adjust these inputs so that we can get a better overall customer lead time or overall total project duration. So let's say that I had 2 zones here, right? And I'll just do this easily. And I've got 2 activities that I'm analyzing. If I switch to 4 zones, and yes, I've shown you this in other videos, but it's super important, and I've decreased the zone sizes by half, then this activity here will only be half, right? And the production rhythm will look something like that. And if I bring that second activity down, it will look exactly like that. And you'll see the original end date versus your new end date. These are very, very different. So in construction, from a builder standpoint, the reason that you need to understand takt time is because when you package it into wagons and you identify the number of zones you have, and you proportionally adjust your zones and your takt time together, you get a shorter duration. From a builder standpoint, this is the same area, same amount of work, same people, same area, same amount of work, same people. But they finish sooner simply because we have adjusted zone sizes and adjusted takt times. So the reason that you want to understand takt time is because on projects, you can go a lot faster without ever hurting people simply by understanding the takt time formula or the Little's Law formula for takt production system in construction, or what we call Louis and Binegar's Law. So this is the formula. The reason you want to understand cycle time is because we often do not understand exactly how the different steps in your cycle time affect the overall duration of that cycle time. Let me give you an example. Most of the time, like let's say in this preparation to the activity, let's say that you had your first activity, your second activity, right? Your third activity, your fourth, your fifth, and let's say that this was how long the actual activity took. Let's say that in steps number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you needed to analyze that overall cycle time to see what's going on. One of the first things you do is find out what is value add, non-value add necessary, non-value add unnecessary. If you go through here, a lot of times you'll find out, oh my gosh, there are steps in the process that are non-value add, not necessary. So maybe, you know, if this is the activity, well, the punch list was a waste of time. And actually, if we pre-kit, most of the activity or the duration for step number 2 is not needed. And actually, the overall cycle time isn't what it originally showed. The actual cycle time could be much shorter. So one of the first things that we do is to look at every step in the process to see if there are any non-value add, not necessary steps. Now, the reason is to eliminate waste. Why is this a problem? You're probably like, Jason, this is pretty common sense. The problem is, in construction, we're only ever focused on the activity duration. We're only ever focused on how fast is the worker going, how fast is the install going. We're not focused on how long it takes to get them the information. We're not focused on how long it takes to mobilize. We're not focused on how the crane held them up. We're not focused on how long it takes them to move from area to area, any wasted steps, any roadblocks, any interruptions, any missed handoffs, any impacts, any delayed materials, right? If we look at the whole thing from start to finish, we can start to analyze waste, because the production on our project sites is not just from this activity time right here. OK, Okay, it's the overall cycle time. So the overall project team to pull these two concepts together should be looking at takt time and evaluating how we should zone the overall building and actually complete on a takted rhythm. And then foremen should be looking at not just the activity time, but actually the duration from the time it starts to the time it finishes, and looking for those non-value added activities, shortening the cycle times and getting better at everything that we do. And the most important concept here is do not push workers, analyze the process. So the takeaway from this video is project teams, analyze your takt time, foreman, analyze your cycle time, look for waste, do not waste time here, and do not waste time here. This is the difference between takt time and cycle time. And we're gonna give you in the description below, in exchange for some likes and some comments, we're gonna give you some really cool graphics on Canva that explain these concepts so that you tomorrow can go out and win with takt time and cycle time. On we go.